Dada yangu namuita Rebecca.
And this sister we call him Rebecca.
Na
Na njo chinaki.
Njo chinako. Mungu wangu. Mungu wangu.
Prophecy.
Na hii baraka yote ya Rebecca ikufuate kwa jina.
Amen.
Alafu
now, amen.
Alafu sisi hapa ni mfano tu.
And we are just an example.
Mfano tu, mfano hii sio farasi, tu mfano tu.
Just an example.
Our farasi.
These are horses.
Sikiza mfano.
Listen to the revelation.
Like Abraham.
Abraham.
Elias alikuwa mfanyakazi wa Abraham. Najua kuna watu wengi wasoma Biblia. Elias alikuwa mfanyakazi wa Abraham.
Elias was a servant of Abraham.
Asa Abraham.
Now Abraham.
Amemtuma Elias.
Sends Elias.
Aende kumtafutia Isaac.
To go and look Isaac.
Mke wa huyo.
A wife to marry.
Rebecca.
Rebecca.
Hajua kitu ndani katika jamii.
She doesn't know what is going on in this family.
Hajua kabisa.
She doesn't know anything.
Hajua kabisa.
She doesn't know anything.
Nini itasaidia Rebecca?
What is going to help Rebecca?
Kuelewa.
To understand.
Kitu ndani katika jamii.
What to know what is going on.
Ni uwezo wa Mungu juu yake.
It's the power of God on her.
Itapatia ufunuo.
It's going to give her a revelation.
Wa kujua kitu cha kufanya.
Of knowing what to do.
Neema ya Mungu inaweza kuja kwako.
The grace of God can come to you.
Lakini useme ya kwamba.
But you'll say that.
Hiyo ni kawaida.
Now that is normal.
Tuasikiaga hizo vitu.
We just hear those things.
Lazima uwe na huu umwapo ndani ya kawaida.
God has to take care of it.
Wakati wote unaona mtumishi wako.
Every time you see a man of God.
Anza kuchukua neema kutoka.
Make sure that you have to break some grace from.
Maana kila mtumishi wa Mungu.
Because every minister of God.
Anatembea na neema.
They walk with their grace.
Sikiza.
Listen.
Eliezer akasimama
yeye chini
jerada kule na kitia akiwa njiani.
When he was on his way,
akaenda
and then he came
kwa kisima kapo.
He went on the well
kapo
la pool.
Wakati alikuwa anaenda
anatenda chwas there,
uwezo wa Mungu juu ya Eliezer,
the strength, the power of God on Eliezer,
akaanza kujiuliza.
And then he started asking himself, so
nitamjuaje mke ambaye,
how am I going to know a woman
atanisaidia,
that is going to help me?
Nitamjuaje mke,
how am I going to understand?
Wanapaka matilo,
now they put on high pants,
wanatoa hii na hii,
now they purify themselves, they put so many things on.
Wanapaka hii na weka kwa mavazi mafiga,
and they put in on short dresses.
Nitamjuaje,
how am I going to discover
mke ambaye ndampelekea bwana wangu?
A woman that I'm going to check for my
master.
And then she started speaking with the power of God. Because Eliezer was not just a
normal.
And then the strength of God
came to him.
And then the power of God told him. And
started
speaking to the spirit of God. That woman that is going to give me water. And then to feed my
master.
She's going to receive a favor in my presence.
Yeah.
To my master.
Nani angeliambia Rebecca mawazo ya mtu mwingine?
Who would have told Rebecca the thinking of another person?
Hakuna.
No one.
Lakini uwezo wa Mungu juu yake.
The spirit of God.
Ilimpatia neema.
Kept me.
Na mimi nasema Yesu ni kweli ndani ya
kawaida. God take care of
you. Yesu ni kweli ndani ya kawaida.
Take care of
you. Yesu ni kweli ndani ya kawaida.
Revelation of the
church.
Receive the grace in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And now, hapo kwa hiyo maji,
there at the pool,
ama hiyo kisima,
there at the pool,
wanawake wengi walikuwa wanakuja pale.
There are so many women that were coming there,
ambao wamekata hii,
who are prepared,
wamekata hii,
wanakuja so many,
wameka wanje na pita kuna utia hapo.
They've put copper gala,
ni sawa, sio vibaya.
It's correct, it's
ambao walivaa nguo,
that put on dress,
washika vizuri,
that are so
nice, wameka kuwa pro.
They look so nice.
Ndio amefanya vizuri.
They dress
well. Ndio anaonekana kuwa mrembo.
They look beautiful.
Lakini hana ufunuo.
But they don't have a revelation.
Kucha na chota maji.
And then they come and
test the form mbele yake.
They fetch the dress is not that they don't need to see that dress.
Za injili. Utajua ukweli.
Listen to the gospel.
Na ukweli za kuweka huko.
The truth is going to set you
free. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Acha vituko ya injili. Sikia Yesu wakati anaongea.
Listen to Jesus when he's speaking.
Bisha maisha yako.
He's going to transform your life.
Tuamini kwa Mungu.
He knows that he has
God.
God has called
him. Akaniambia.
And he told him.
Ndahubiri injili.
And he's going to
mahali pote ndapita.
Everywhere he's going to.
Mahali pote ndapita.
Everywhere he's going to go.
Ambapo nikaribishi.
Wherever he's going to go.
Neema ya Mungu takatifu.
The grace of God is going to
karibisha leo na Mungu aliyekuletea.
Receive one word.
Amen.
The grace that God brought
to
us. Because we leave the kingdom of God. And then we just
sit there.
And then that's where the problem starts from. The
women
are coming.
Rebecca.
But Rebecca.
God. Rebecca.
But Rebecca. She was given a revelation. She came to this well. And she was walking. Who told Rebecca this? When she got to this pool, the Bible testified.
Rebecca
was filled with the Spirit. She got a revelation. She fetched water. She went. And then she gave
it.
Just open your mouth. And then she.
Nani aliambia Rebecca amnyoshe Eliezer?
Who told Rebecca to
quit? Kiwa na uwezo wa Mungu juu yako.
Have the power
ya kutoa ndani ya kawaida.
Let you have
the power. Mahali wengine hawakuona baraka.
Hata kama vile tu ya kuona. When you going to see
the tena kwa jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Others don't see that
first.
The problem is you have to fight in the
church.
But they say this. Where did the time go? Where did the
focus go?
What are you saying? Come to church and follow Jesus.
It's
going to give you a revelation. Even if you're a preacher, you have to get a revelation to change your ministry. Amen. Amen.
Rebecca fetched water and gave it
to Eliezer.
Nani aliambia Rebecca ya kwamba?
Who told Rebecca that?
Eliezer
anahitaji maji. That Eliezer required water.
Alihitaji ufunuo kutoka.
She needed a revelation from God.
Kutoka ndani ya ukawaida.
If you come out of the ordinary.
Kila wakati.
Every time.
Mungu anakupatia neema.
God is going to give you grace.
Mungu anakupatia neema.
God gives you.
Ndio maana wanafunzi Yesu.
And that's why the disciples.
Walikuwa na uwezo.
When they were filled with the
kanisa ya kwanza.
The first church.
Hakukua kiburi.
There was no
pride.
Vita. There was no fight.
Hakukua matetano.
There was no gossip.
There
was no
corruption.
Mengi.
There was the
power of God.
Watu walipendana.
They loved each other.
Watu wengine walikosa pesa ya nyumba.
So did have.
Na ndugu anauza nyumba yake. Kwa ajili ya kucha kumtetea mwenzake.
Kama ni
upendo wa kanisa la kwanza
uishi. And that's why the church is not
growing.
Instead of making
sepake go down.
He also wanted to break sepake.
No,
you don't have the unity. You don't have the
love. No,
you don't have love. You just want you to be glorified. God is the one who brings glory. Our Father knows. We are here, there are just people
that
Pastor Tito knows. Because sometimes when he preaches,
I know what it will be.
Like, how come this man is preaching? Because they know
him.
Because they fought with them so much. They change your ways, do this and that. They could not listen to the
advice.
But if God has a project with you,
if
God has a plan with you, even if you run away, God is going to locate you because he has a plan with you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Haya. Nafunzana za 3 hours lakini basi. Haya, chota maji.
Now get more water.
Rebecca akachota alipomaza kunywesha Eliezer.
After giving water to Eliezer,
chota maji.
She also went and put fresh water
ala Eliezer. Patia farasi ya kwanza.
Now give the first horse. She gives the second horse. She's giving to the third one. That for one who wants to be sacrificed
in water,
in so many parts of water. Now tell me, how many times did Rebecca move around fetching water and feeding the horses? When you're serving God, you don't know that it's going to be
trouble.
But what you know, you just have to come early in church. That I've given you. Remind Jesus.
Abraham is an example of God.
Eliezer is the Holy Spirit.
Isaac is the church.
Isaac is Jesus.
Abraham is the image of God.
Eliezer is the image of the Holy Spirit.
Isaac is the image of Jesus Christ.
Rebecca is the church.
And then the horses is an example of the grace.
Receive the blessings of God.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, touch your neighbor, say,
take my number right now. Because after here, God is going to do great things. It's going to be. Because when you get a revelation, now you've got in a light. Now, this is where
we're
going to finish from. And we laugh.
Rebecca now.
She's buried.
Oh, hell.
Let's say Jesus. God can hide your shame so that you can go for glory. Because Rebecca was buried. But God in heaven.
Because
the power was on her life.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah. The power was on her life.
It gave her a
revelation. Then God hid
her.
And then she just went into the family. And then when she walked into the harvest, and then God gave her grace. And then God made him become the father of the nations. Hallelujah. Raise your hands. Raise your hands. Tell Jesus of mercy that you're in the presence. Tell Jesus that you're here.
But you follow.
Give me a revelation.
The
word of Rebecca is the same word yesterday to them.
We are
talking to people that are tired. Because there's no one that's going to be
hospitalized.
Because the revelation
is going to be
hospitalized. Jesus.
If you had any
problems, raise your hands. I tell God of prosperity. Give me a revelation. The Father has come. It's not just a
prayer.
Pray for His grace. And respect the
power.
God of glory.
I was a
God of
glory.
I'm also going to do this.
And
the grace of God is going to work in my life. Raise your hands. Of the Holy Communion. Your life is not going to be the same. God is faithful. God has sent me. Because He knew
that
He went to
talk.
And the power of
God.
Praise of God. Just think. Recollect me.
Keep on fire.
What have you done?
May my mom to find a case for my share.
Holding your Christmas.
Because you guys are fire wells for my share.
What has done?
Come and invite me.
If it's a
sin, I'll be a mom.
Just tell God.
What has he done?
What is time?
What is a man in the bed?
Help me today. God has the power to bless your life. It's not because of your business. God is just going to change your life. God is just going to change your
life.
And your life is going to be transformed. God is here. The last place
that I
remember. God is healing this
man.
God is opening ways. Don't look at us. He doesn't have
anything.
But God has seen him. He has so many great things.
Raise
your hand to Jesus. I'm here to receive. Jesus heals you.
Yes,
people.
Yes, we are going to take a mission.
Jesus,
now we are going to have an idea. What?
We are saying people.
In that shall we come and
meet
them.
Now
we are going to have
a
mission.
Now
we are going to have a mission.
Hallelujah.
Mungu atatuma wazungu.
God is going to send white people.
Wakuje wajenge sepaka hapa.
Come and build the sepaka.
Mungu atakupatia ufunuo wewe.
God is going to give you a revelation.
Kubariki sahi.
He is going to bless you more.
Njia yote ile.
In every way.
Ili upate kuwa baraka juu ya
sasa. That can be a blessing to
this church. Upate kuwa baraka juu ya mchungaji wewe.
That can be a blessing
to our baraka juu ya wazee wewe.
That can be a blessing
to the church. Upate kuwa baraka juu ya kanisa mzima.
That can be a blessing to the entire church.
Hey, your name.
Receive that stress in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The grace of God is located. The grace of God is located.
Luke 5:17.
Yes, when Jesus was teaching, the power of God was
here.
Because it was the
ways of the
power. Don't look at your
neighbor.
Don't see what you're
doing.
Your neighbor knows your name.
But he doesn't
know what you're doing.
If
Rebecca did what she did, and she saw the hand of God,
she can
ask and see the hand of God.
We
pray that everybody was here. We believe God's
word.
Because when you see your soul, in that grace, for such grace, get a good offering.
Like
that tell the Father.